Hi guys. Hey.
Hi.
So I just thought, it's a Sunday. I've got a Monday for one more day here in Argentina. So I thought I'd come on and do a little Instagram live tutorial kind of thing. Hello, Flor.
Hey, from Denmark.
Hey, Denmark.
Island, a lot of diamonds.
What kind of look do you guys want me to do? Let me know.
I'm here for that.
Yeah.
You're so pretty.
Yes, she is.
Gracias. Gracias, Carol.
Obrigado. Obrigada. Obrigada.
Obrigado.
Obrigado.
You're a boy.
Oh, so even if I'm saying it to a girl, I still need to say obrigado.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm going to just take a little bit of eye base. Blown out smoky. I feel like I'm feeling very blown out smoky today. Okay. Got the best face ever, guys. It's like not even fair.
Gracias.
Like every makeup artist in the world needs to do her makeup at least once in a lifetime. Promise. So fly out, guys. I promise it's worth it. I wish I could play music, guys, but I feel like Instagram shuts you down when you play music.
Yeah. Because not yours.
Yeah. So.
Like only you can hear your music.
It's okay. We'll just speak. Our voices will be the music. Yes, I'm here at Natasha Nina today. She's not actually here yet, she's with Tiana, her baby. Perfect baby. I love her, so cute. Like, honestly, the cutest. She's so funny.
Yeah.
I think we're all gonna go around to Natasha's later on for a barbecue. Do you know what a barbecue is? When I say that. Okay.
Yeah. You want me to say imperial? So what is a barbecue?
Yeah, what is a barbecue in Portuguese?
Churrasco.
Churrasco.
Oh, you're good.
No, I'm getting it.
Brazilian.
Basically.
Yeah. I'm curious about how is the barbecue here?
Yeah, I can imagine a lot of meat.
Yeah,
obviously. Always.
But I don't know if it's the same as in Brazil.
A barbecue back at home is basically like sausages.
No.
Oh yeah, that's what a barbecue is at home.
Burgers.
Maybe? What? Like burgers.
I don't know what is a burger.
A burger? Yeah, a burger.
In Brazil you don't know burgers?
Oh yeah, oh wait, no,
it's like beef and beef and beef then.
Crazy how we all do it differently.
and garlic bread. I'm so anxious. Garlic bread, you know what this?
Yeah, garlic bread. Oh, we don't really have them. I don't have them for
You never tried?
Well, yeah, but I don't know. That's not really a barbecue kind of thing. Like, we don't really do that for a barbecue.
In Brazil, you do. Only on barbecue.
Okay, so I'm going to use Pili Wee's palette.
Again?
Yes. I'm going to use this eyeshadow. Again.
You're going to make a hole.
Mm-hmm. Love this color. This year, because I've done a lot of South America now, my goal is to do more Asia and that side.
You want to do?
Yeah, I
want to
visit Asia. You know, instead of doing this continent, I want to do like a different continent now.
Yeah, I want to do this too.
I just love the Asian culture, like the, you know, like in Tokyo and stuff like that. Just like it's so cool and love to go and visit. Do you like Chinese food? Oh my god, Shay, don't, because I really just want to fly you out here right now so I can paint you as well, so would love to come and do that right now. Yeah, wait, do you like Chinese food?
Yeah. Wait, you don't?
I love Chinese food. One of my favourites, like, you know, like a takeaway from back at home, that's my takeaway.
But sushi, you don't.
Not sushi. I like things being cooked and fried.
No.
But I'll be honest, I'm trying to stay away from unhealthy foods at the minute. I'm trying to really.
Sushi is health.
Yeah, but it's raw.
That is?
It's like uncooked a lot of the time.
What's the problem?
Yeah, that just freaks me out. I had Chinese last night. Oh, what did you have from the Chinese? So really at the minute I'm just measuring the height, and then this is going to be quite a blown out eye, so I do need to make sure that my dark colour comes up quite high. But at the same time, you obviously don't want to take it up too high to the point where you can't fit any other colours on, so just be really mindful when you're doing this bit, where you're going with your product. Come to Scandinavia, ooh! Eventually, I want to visit every place in the world, like especially where I've got followers. That'd be amazing. Tomorrow, I fly to Bolivia. And I don't know how long I'm there for, but I'm there, I think, for a few days. Got a class in Bolivia. And after that, I think it's Ecuador? Or maybe Colombia? One or the other. And then we've got Guatemala, we've got the Dominican Republic, we've got Panama. I'm excited. Any questions, guys? Come to Britain. I'm coming soon. Coming back soon. Promise. I miss home.
No.
I actually normally don't feel homesick, but this time I think because I know that I'm away for so long, and I am getting a bit homesick this time. That's why when I see Tiana, I'm just obsessed because it's like having a little family. At the minute, I'm just tapping around the edges just to soften that edge a little bit. I know how Louise, how amazing is her face. Are you doing France? So I am actually coming to France later this year for a class. I'm just waiting to find out a bit more about the details, like the dates and the location. It'll be in Paris though. But yeah, still early days of planning, but I'm coming, don't worry. I'll be there. So to sort of soften the edge, I'm then going to go into a Morphe brush. This is a Morphe M433. And now I'm going to go into the Stacey Marie palette. And so I'm going to take this purple. And I've just got glitter everywhere because I'm...
You can put it in front.
She's also a very good palette holder. She's good at everything. So I'm going to take the shade Wasted. On the edges of that first eyeshadow just to really intensify how purple the eye is. I'm doing this because she's got beautiful green eyes, so this will really bring out the green in her eyes. Let me know if you've got any questions, guys, regarding product, meek. Yeah, to help. I don't do live very often, so I'll get the most out of it. Hi, Yole. I miss you. Can you chat about what you should have in your beginner kit? So I always say this, I think in anyone's kit, I think you need a really good eyeshadow base. Whether that's a really thick concealer, whether it's an actual eyeshadow base. I just think everyone needs an eyeshadow base, especially for the looks that I do. I think it's so important that you really need to know that you can't create like something really intense with your look if you've not got something to work on top of. So eye base for me is crucial. I think you need quite a few shades of foundation just so then you can be ready for whoever sits in your seat. I loved MAC when I started out because the shade range is really easy to get. So it was really easy for me to understand. But now I feel like there's so many more brands out there that are better, even more affordable brands as well. But my favourite is Fenty. that then it's got a really inclusive shade range, it's really easy to understand. Which I think is kind of crucial when you're first starting out. You don't want to be buying things and not kind of understanding what you're actually buying. But that's kind of a nightmare. I think with eyeshadows, just get a few palettes. Even if you don't want to spend loads on palettes, you can just get a few Morphe palettes. They're always amazing. What shades are you using? So I'm using the P. Louise Love Shy, this one. And then the Wasted by Stacey Marie, the purple.
Strong.
It's strong, okay. Too strong.
Yeah.
Yeah, Stacey Marie and a few weeks palette. But I'll be honest, you could do this with either palette and you don't need both. I just like these two eyeshadows mixed together. But they both have similar, very similar tones in. So you could just use either or palette. One or the other. Okay, so now I'm going to take a Natasha Nina brush. This is a D28. This is honestly one of my favourite brushes ever. It's so, so small. Like, look at the size difference. So good. It's not even smaller than, say, like a 221. Obsessed. And I'm going to go in with this blue. I'm going to take this up a little bit higher. Just go sideways with my brush. Because we've got that bright purple, the blue will just really easily melt into it. Yeah, this brush has honestly changed my life. It makes everything so easy, especially when you're blending. And if I was to describe the pressure that I'm using, my pressure is so, so light, guys. It's so important that this pressure is light. I'm actually basically just gonna scrape away the base. Important that your blue, each shade lighter that we're using, it's going to come out further and up further as well. That's basically what a blend is. So it's really important you really do that quite well. Yeah, Natasha Nina D28. Favorite brushes for an eye look, so I'd definitely say it really depending on what base I'm using, but I like a MAC 221, I like a D28 by Natasha Nina, I like a Crown C511, but I mix up my brushes depending on the eye look. But I do prefer smaller brushes. Smaller brushes for me are always much easier to get a cleaner finish with. I always like my blend in my crease to be quite clean. I don't really like to see sort of a bit too blown out, and I don't like to lose my colours too much. So that's why I do prefer smaller brushes. But then if you want it more of a blown out crease, I think it's better to use bigger brushes, because that way you're going to loosen the blend a little bit more. Then I'm gonna get it to open and look straight ahead. I'm just almost gonna bring this underneath the eye as well. Just a little bit, just so then we can then connect our lash line later on. Yeah, so these are the palettes that I'm using. For anyone that didn't know. I'm just gonna clean up that brush and I'm gonna go in with the shade Mint. I'm just gonna come up a little bit higher.
This green is really beautiful.
It's pretty. Do you have a plan to the makeup look? No, I never really plan the makeup look unless I've obviously been given an objective and like a plan. But I very rarely plan my makeup looks. I feel like sometimes when I plan my makeup looks, that's when I lose my creativity. Whereas if I just kind of go into it and just look at a palette, I'll look at a shimmer and kind of base it around that. That way, I just get a little bit more frisky with my ideas. And I don't limit myself then to like what I could do. What was that? Did you say that?
Hackers. Yeah.
Yeah, oh my god, don't say that.
Hmm?
What if it actually was a hacker?
No, not a hacker. I hope. It's okay.
I'm like, what? Okay, so I'm just gonna go back through my colours and build them back up. Go now into the bright purple. And as I go in the second time with my colours are almost going to rise a little bit. Get a little bit higher. Can you zoom out, please? Well, I'm just trying to show the eye, so maybe in a little bit I'll zoom out.
And they ask for more zoom.
More zoom in. So now I'm just going in with our sky blue shade. Oh my god, what is happening? Guys, I think I'm being hacked.
But you're not, I think so.
That's me. So this bush, guys, is a Natasha Nina D28. That is. Such a good bush, guys. It makes blending so easy. Is it synthetic? Yes, it is a synthetic brush recall. It's like it almost feels a little bit like one of the newer MAC 221s, but smaller. So because it's smaller, it kind of doesn't feel like scratchy. Such a good brush. So I always just like to go back in with my darkest colour and just make sure that's nice and dark, nice and built and intense. So important. I'm going to go in with a black all over the eyelids. So I'm going to take a black gel liner. This is the Natasha Nina gel liner. Guys, don't sleep on these products. They're so good. Like, so good. Like, I can't explain how good some of these products are. And I'm going to take this on a Morphe M456. It's just her black gel liner. And this is a really nice black gel liner because it really, it dries really matte, but it's really easy to blend at the same time. So it's Natasha. N-I-N-A. Natasha Nina. I'm starting low, and then I'm slowly bringing it higher. That way it'll take the edge away of the black and allow it to blend into these darker colours in the crease. But you need to be slow when you do this, especially when you're working with a good gel liner. Natasha Nina brush. I think you can just get it on the Natasha Nina website. But if you're going to get some guys, especially if you're from a little bit further away, get quite a few. And it'll just be so much more worth it. I'd say get at least 3. Down at me. Open. Okay. And I do like to get it to open and look down into that corner when I do the inner corner, just so then I don't get it too close to the actual inner tear duct. Will this be said? Yeah? Of course. It'll be on for like 24 hours, but obviously if you guys want to really keep any steps forever, just like screenshot or screen record. I love when I see people screen recording live, so then they can't like keep them. So cool. Such a good idea. Sure, this is right into the lash line. God.
What do you need?
It's the white.
Hmm?
I've seen a white, I need a white. Tell me again.
Oi, Bianco, ele ver oficial. Thank you, Rebel Child. You found?
Yeah, I'll get them in a minute.
Hmm?
I'll get them in a minute, it's okay. So now, guys.
Ooh.
I'm gonna take a pigment by Ana Paula Marcal. Marcel. And this is in the shade 262. I'm just going to take this all the way over the black. So just putting this onto the very centre of the lid. And when she looks down and closes it, just kind of twinkles a little bit. I'm not really putting it on the outer corners because I'm going to set that with some black eyeshadow. I don't really want to put this all over the lid because then you'll lose the dimension of the depth. which it's your mum and Mel watching. Hi mum, I miss you so much. Hi Mel, I miss you. Say hi to my mum.
Hi Mitchell's mum. That's so beautiful.
I wish she was here, mum. Mm. Miss you so much.
Any questions?
No. Yeah. Mulher pergunta ele, are you going to save this one? Yeah. Yeah, sim, ele vai salvar. So I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills black eyeshadow.
Hi, Natasha.
Oh, my other mum is here. Natasha and my mum. Two mamas. And I'm going to set the outer corners of the eye with the black eyeshadow. Yes, the model is beautiful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yes, you are.
Yeah.
Love it.
That's okay if I...
Exactly. It's perfect.
See, so I was about myself.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's saying...
If I let you, I'd be like, yep, I am. Why did you make it look so easy? I'll be honest, it's just practice. A lot of practice, guys. Emma? Mike's here. I think. Natasha just said Mike.
Natasha, say hi to Tiana.
Do you have a sketch that's coming up? No, but I do come up with ideas in my notes. I come up with a lot of ideas in my notes. So I spend a lot of my flights, I'll just write down ideas in my notes, on my phone. So let's hope no one ever steals my phone because they'll steal all my ideas. Black a little bit along the lash line as well, just to keep it really smoky. What's your model's name? Introduce yourself.
My name is Amanda.
Amanda. I know what I can do. You entertain.
Okay. Hi guys. Paula, eu tô tentando, mas é difícil. O vídeo não tá em agosto. Thank you! I can't read your name. Hi Mike!
Hi Mike!
Here.
I
think they're cottons. Yeah. Are in my bag?
I've got some here.
Thanks, Dad. I have a. Oh, you have it too.
You tried this. So, guys, I'm gonna try this. It's like an eye makeup remover. It's so good. But yesterday I had a lot of stuff on the back of my.
There's oil on it?
Yeah, it's like silicone, so it kind of just slips, but then it doesn't stay oily.
This is way better than the... What's the name of the thing you use? Like a... You put, I don't know how to say it in English.
Micellar water.
This?
Micellar.
No, this.
Oh, wipes.
Wipes.
Yeah. I didn't even have them wipes.
Huh?
I didn't know they were there.
I hate it. Hurt my skin.
Do we like? What's the dust you blow over your model's face to make them glow, please? Well, if I told you that, I'd have to kill you. No, I'm joking. No, so it's basically just a pigment, just like Peaches and Cream, Bollywood, oh, it's always really beautiful. Peaches and Cream, Bollywood is pretty. You can, to be fair, you can do it with any pigment you want. Even sometimes I'll do it with like mermaids, like something a bit more blue. But it just depends what look you're going for. But Bollywood is beautiful on any skin, especially darker skin. It's so stunning over dark skin.
Perfect face.
Do you like the James Charles and Marker palette? Yeah, I love it. Love that purple shimmer in it. It's stunning. It's a beautiful topper. Can't wait to see the finished product. Yeah, me too. I don't know if I'm finished with this eye yet. I do feel like I want to add more, but that's just me always.
I don't know how Summer and the girl had a conversation. Because I was supposed to be helping, but I was sleeping.
You're like,
wow. I was like, yeah.
So I'm going to go in with a Barry M holographic eyeshadow topper. This is in the shade Asteroid. Asteroid.
What concealer you use, Fenty?
What contour? Yeah, I change it. What?
No,
constantly. I use a Pilates base with the Fenty underneath the brow, but then the Pilates all over.
Of course. I already know your step by
yes,
step.
Yes, you do.
I can.
She said it on that much, many times that she just knows.
I can sell it later. Like a book.
Yes, literally. Yeah, it's kind of similar to Mermaid's. It's just more like a liquid eyeshadow formula. No, this is not Jeffrey's palette. I wish it was Jeffrey's palette, but it's not. But Jeffrey's palette is insane. It looks so beautiful in all the pictures as well. Such a photogenic palette, sorry. Would you start with brows? I do brows at like the very last step normally, just because that way I can really sense what kind of intensity I want to go with my brow. So guys, I'm gonna do the other side now that I'm not wondering. So you might be bored of seeing this by now, but maybe I'll come back and do it. Or do you want me to just carry on doing it and I'll do it again? Let me know. Or do you want me to go off and then come back when I've done it?
Because I hate things. El peso al vivo hace mucho. Tú no hablas español muy bien.
What's that?
I just stated that I don't understand what she was asking.
Continue. Okay. Okay.
Stay.
Solid talk.
Come off.
Oh, stay. Well, Marvin was asking. Yeah.
Stay.
Okay, cool. Begging. So for anyone that didn't see this the first time, this is for you guys. This is for you. Do it again. Okay. So I'm starting off with the Pee Wee's Love Shy eyeshadow. And this is on a Crown C511 brush. Yeah, she is finished. She's got a sass. Blend the edges. Hello. Have you seen this blend? Did you see that? Am I on looking at the wrong guy here? Don't come for the blend. Just don't do it. Yeah, guys, that's all I'm all about. I'm all about just learning. How do you determine the shape and where to put the clothes? So I always like to start off with my darker colour first. So I always like to start just in the crease or where her natural socket line is. But then depending on where I put the colours, it really depends on how dramatic I want to go. So as I increase the height of my eyeshadow, if I want to keep it more dramatic, I'll go really close to the brow. But then if I want to keep it a little bit softer, I just want to take dark colours up as high. But most of the time, I just go all the way up. Oh, thank you. So the palettes I've used, guys, just in case anyone's missed it, is the Pee Wee's Secret Sinner and the Stacey Marie Carnival palette. Can you come to Mexico? Yes, I'm actually coming to Mexico in July.
Ooh.
I think it's called Tuscan, I think that's where I'm going. Huh? Is that what it's called? I'll find out the area where it is, the location, the city.
Cusco.
Tuscan?
With the C? Or with the T?
I think with the T.
The T, so I don't know. Probably it's this.
It's like towards the bottom of Mexico, like kind of near like Guatemala and probably not near, to be fair. It's a very big country, but in that direction. Come to Spain. That's not so relaxing. Could you do my makeup? Yeah. Just flying over to Argentina now.
Why'd she ask?
If I can do a makeup. Because it looks relaxing. Is it relaxing? For you?
If I am relaxing?
When I do your makeup, is it relaxing? Does it relax you?
Yeah, yeah. I'm almost sleeping.
Yes.
All the time. I already slept on this day, like a lot of times. I just got like.
Okay, I'm gonna throw that bit to this side.
I have a big face and my nose is too small for my big
face.
Yeah.
Not what your face is about.
I need to show you everything. I can totally close my nose.
Oh.
Like.
Oh, cute. I love it.
Cute.
I'd walk around like that.
I think it's a gift. I never met anyone.
Gift from God.
Hola.
Hola, chica.
It's like my lashes. Oh my God.
Lord China's here. Oh my God, they're
ooh.
Oh my God, they look like
real
individual lashes.
How good is she?
Beautiful, yeah. They don't look fake.
Yeah. Yeah. Really beautiful.
Oh.
You're a full-time barb now.
I'm so hard trying to keep my... Now I know how makeup models can cope sometimes.
Did you keep it close for the whole?
I did. But I was struggling.
I don't know how people do that. My friend gets hers done. My best friend Harley, and she like when I do her makeup, she can't even sit there for 2 minutes. So I don't know how she does it.
It's hard. So I commend people like makeup models now.
Like, you have to sit there for the whole time.
So what are we doing, girls? It's so pretty. Look at that blue around the perimeter. Is that sky?
Yeah. I'll mix it with a little bit of that.
The mint, no?
Yeah, a little bit of mint.
Beautiful. Do you know what I love about the sky? See, because when it mixes in with the base, it almost turns into mint.
Yeah, literally. It's beautiful. Yeah. I find that with a lot of blues though.
Yeah, they go like a greeny.
I used to find that blues were really hard to blend, but now that people are bringing out my blue eyeshadows.
I'd actually say they're the easiest.
Yeah.
Blue and purple.
Literally. If you just wanted to keep it purple and blue, you can almost just blend it with one eyeshadow.
Exactly. And I love how blue can go so many tones, like with the amount of pigment you put
exactly.
on. Exactly. Do you know what I mean? Amazing. So talented. Is that
Astrid?
No.
Yeah, Astrid. Astrid.
Oh, hen.
Yeah, be hen. Have we got any fellow Scottish people in the live?
I won't show my face, but I look like Hagrid's son.
We Hagrid hen. I actually feel like I'm with Laurie when I'm with you. I love it.
Yeah.
I don't need to go home.
I know, I'll just speak all the time.
Just send me voice notes. Hey, Hen.
Hi, Hen. How are you?
Oh, there's a few Scottish gals. Yeah, hey, guys. Yeah, I'm Scottish. Loads of Scottish people. Say hi.
Hi, guys.
You didn't sound very Scottish then.
Alright, guys,
how are you?
Yeah,
how are you,
Hen? How are you?
Love it.
I think I'll go do my makeup and then.
Can you do it in here? Get ready with us?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. I'm gonna make my face.
Okay. See you soon, Hen.
Hello from Birmingham. Someone let me see the lashes. Oh, Natasha wants to see the lashes. They look beautiful, the lashes.
Yeah, full time Barbie.
That looks like your host. My time's all short.
Oh, here.
Oh, okay.
Come and show your lashes. Just dip your head in. So she said, what is the type of lashes like? Semi-permanent.
Kind of Russian volume.
Russian volume.
Or.
Gorgeous. What's her name? The girl that does it.
I've got a username. She's in
there. I think Natasha. And she's very in the light. Can go